So it is 2:08. So it's been over 2 hours, and I'm heading back to get on the blood trail. Hopefully find this buck. We'll see what happens. All right, guys, we're back at the tree stand. And, right up in there is where I shot. And now it's 2:15, so almost 2.5 hours. So I'll take you back down to the blood and we'll start from there. All right, so just got back to the original shot. And see the blood there going through here, blood's all over. And, I didn't look for my arrow last time. I wonder if the arrow went through him. So the original, let's see. I don't see it. Check this out, I was looking for my arrow. And you can see this is from about 2 feet from the place of impact, and there's just blood splatter. You can see the directional path, especially on that leaf. It's just blood splatter all the way through here. So it had to be a solid shot. Alright, I can't find my arrow, so I'm just gonna try and start tracking it by blood. I'll keep you all updated. Holy crap. Look, here's the arrow. Oh wow, look at this. That's a clean, look at that blood, man. All the way through. Broadhead still intact. Wow. That's so cool, check it out. All right. Well, that's a very good sign. Let's hope he's up here a little ways. I'm gonna leave this arrow right here. Alright guys, so I've been tracking him. Been using these right here. Cause after the arrow, it's been dried up so much on these brown leaves, but I was able to get down here to the bottom. And I can even see his tracks. And look at this. That's a big deer. It's a big deer. And there's blood right beside it. There's a nice splatter right there. 2:58. Look at this blood I found. Still bright pink. Going up through here. Here's some more. That's good looking blood right there. Okay, wow, I'm finding a lot more blood. And he's gonna turn to go back towards my house. Holy cow. Look at this. Look at that right there. Oh, I'm in the front. Look at that. That's, wow. I can't believe it. Alright, he's going back towards my house. I just gotta show you guys something. So here's the blood that I've been tracking and then gone in a circle. There's one of my other tree stands. And on top of the hill is my backyard, more or less. Check this out here. I don't know if he stopped right here. I mean, he's still got running blood up in that leaf. And he turned now this hill. Looks like he's headed up to my neighbor's. Alright, so he definitely turned, did not go up the hill, he's staying on this trail, right through there. And blood's pretty easy to track. Hope he didn't go too far. Alright guys, it's not going too well, it's 3:30. I can't find any more blood after we got up on the hill, but I've been following these tracks right here, this trail, for about 50 yards so far. I mean, it's gotta be him, because they're so freaking big and it looks like he's hurt, but the blood's just drying up so fast. Alright, well, it's 4:21 and I lost blood. Came up on top of this hill, it's another deep ravine. And I don't know, can't get on the blood. Don't know where he went. This is sad. This is not good. Alright, so still lost the blood. It's 4:52. But the ravine that goes back up in here, I'm quite certain he crossed that ravine at some point. So I'm going to walk up it, see if I can find where he crossed, get back on the trail. Holy crap. I crossed that ravine. Found a spot where it looked like he came up and I was just following by his tracks. And I found this. And then I came across that. I still see his tracks, so let's hope. Wow, that was a long. It's 5:08. You know, where all the silt is filled in here, in this creek. There's trees. We're in the sand now. Hey, I'm back and still can't find any more blood since I crossed the ravine. I've done swept all the way down this creek line, back up the hill, and can't find anything else. The only thing I can imagine, if he ran in my neighbor's backyard or something. I mean, they got kids out there. I'm not trying to walk through people's yard, I guess, looking for blood. I'm definitely pretty disappointed at the moment. Thought I had a good hit on it. But I don't know, that might be it. Okay, well, this was the last piece of blood that I could find. And I'm right back behind my neighbors. So he may have gone up there. The sun's getting ready to go down. I still gotta go back and get some stuff from my stand. Tomorrow morning I'm gonna get up, talk to my neighbors, let them know I'm back here. And I don't know, maybe I'll get lucky. But I've already swept a lot. But oh well. Man, can't believe it. It's the way it goes. Alright. Maybe I'll do a part two or extend this. Alright folks. It's not good news. Couldn't find the deer. It's like 6:18. I'm a little bit upset. Ended up on another neighbor's house. And I'm not sure if it went through their yard. They were back in their yard. I didn't disturb them. But tracked a long ways. Well, it did a loop. But now I'm going back to pick up my crossbow haversack. So tomorrow I'm gonna get out and talk to my neighbors and just scan, walk that area. I mean, I'm just gonna hike the whole thing, weave back and forth. I found deer like that before, so you gotta do it, you gotta try. Alright, that's gonna do it. Sorry it wasn't quite the ending that I had wished. That's the way it goes, man. Alright, thank you for watching. Have a good day. So we came back and with my wife and Gracie, came up here scanning the road for blood, because this is where they came, or this is where he came. Could have been. And just seeing if maybe there's blood on the road. All right, it's 7:10, and still walking the road, checking for blood. The obvious spots where I know they always cross, I didn't see anything, but I'll probably scan the road again tomorrow.